parallel diagonals bisect each other. And opposite angles are equal. All right. The converse. This is true for all parallelograms. This will happen in all parallelograms. Now the converse, what does that mean? The converse means that if you see some special property between any two sides of a quadrilateral or any angles, can you call it a parallelogram? Yes, but what are those special? A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if, what are the special properties? Number one, opposite sides are equal. That means if I have a quadrilateral and I say opposite sides are equal, then I can show that it is a parallelogram. Okay, so that's the first one. The only thing I know, it is a quadrilateral with opposite sides equal. So then I can conclude from that it is a parallelogram. Opposite angles are equal. And the third one, diagonals are equal. So, please take this down also and try to use it. Now, from the Concise Maths book, there is a theorem. I don't think I'll do that just now. There are some theorems to be done there. I would have liked to teach you from the Concise Maths book, but I'll do that later in another class. I'll just do a few questions now from the Innovative Maths book. Okay? Next time, we'll continue this class to do Concise Maths theorems. Let me do one or two questions from exercise 16.2. Based on these properties, based on what I have said here and here. Okay, so exercise 16.2. In study of quadrilaterals and special types of quadrilaterals, it's very important to understand the properties. Exercise 16.2. Let me do one or two questions as time is getting over. Question 1. What does it say? In the parallelogram ABCD, it is given like this. In the parallelogram ABCD, okay, find angle A, B, C, and D. This is given. So find angle A, B, C, and D. So for that you must know the properties of a parallelogram. What are they? Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite angles are equal. Let's do this. Now, angle A is equal to 75 degrees. This angle is equal to 75 degrees. For what reason? Because since AB is parallel to DC, AB is parallel to DC. So this becomes what? corresponding angles. If you remember parallel lines, now angle A and angle C will be equal. Why? Opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. So in geometry you must write the reasons. Now angle A and angle B, or better than that, let me go here, this inside angle, angle D plus 75 degrees, this angle I am looking at, is equal to 180 degrees over here. Why? Linear pair, if you remember that reason from class 7, when two angles are in a straight line and I add them, their sum is 180 degrees. So angle D is 180 degrees minus, that is 105 degrees. And angle B is equal to angle D, 105 degrees. Why? Opposite angles of a parallelogram. I will stop this class today, and I would encourage you to go through exercises 16.1 and 16.2. My time is allotted for today is over. I'll continue this topic, this chapter, from again properties of parallelogram. Maybe I'll use the concise maths book and go through this topic. Thank you.